just kind of understanding your opponent's, like, their range, their spacing. It's yep. just as important as your own, you know.
Their jank, you know, just anything. Okay, so, like, oh, this character has great throw follow-up, so I shouldn't sit and shield so much. Or, oh, this character doesn't have great throw follow-up, so shield's a good answer. Or, you know, whatever it is. This character pressures, this character zones, all that sort of thing.
You know, there, it even comes down to, like, the smallest nuances. Like, you know, on some characters, you're better off recovering low. Others, you're better off coming high. And it's a lot to learn.
In a game with 58 characters, it's a ton to learn.
Yeah. Although, I wouldn't have been upset if they had a few more.
A few more? Really? I'm not sure about that. It's so much for me.
I didn't vote for them, but I was kind of on the Banjo-Kazooie train when people started saying they wanted that.
That'd be fun. That'd be fun. I do kind of miss the ice climbers, but they have a special place in my heart, I guess.
I would have been happy to see them come back since they brought back everybody else.
Pretty much, like, yeah.
I don't need Pichu or Young Link. Like, we don't need any more Links.
All right, so we're having a run back to Samus and Diddy Kong here, Nameless versus Ganon the Beast. Nameless was the one to knock Ganon the Beast to losers in Winners Finals.
And he's kind of going with that same aggressive approach as last time, kind of getting Samus to force into other options.
Mm-hmm.
We almost saw another kill with those with the rocket pack getting blown up off the stage early.
Another, like, weird exchange.
Of special jetpack shenanigans.
I'm not going to put my money that that's going to happen again, but you never know.
They had me nervous on the edge.
Yeah. Oh, good read. Yeah. Good wait.
Nice patient up air there.
Yeah, I feel like Diddy really benefits from patient plays like that, but a good clean back air from Ganon
Beast. Yeah, strong there.
That is a pretty potent kill move for Samus. She has a good back air.
Yeah, that was all.
Nice.
You know, Nameless was going for that ledge jump, so he didn't have much options coming back to the stage. He had to kind of take that one.
Also, I like Samus can come up with an attack really fast from the ledge, like a fair or an up air like that.
Yeah.
We've seen the past couple times.
And the fair covers a lot of ground coming back.
Yeah, you're almost like forced to shield it if you're like right by the edge and she challenges you. All right, good up smash though. Ooh. Yeah, I really like the way Ganon the Beast is just covering space with these aerials. Like, he makes a lot of really safe landing situations with himself because he's constantly, like, creating this wall of, like, hitboxes.
Ganon
like, with
Beast.
A fair or, like, a back air.
I think he's definitely learned from his earlier set.
Agreed. Yeah, this is a... this game at least is going in Ganon's favor heavily.
I think he's managing the aggressive play a lot better.
Yep.
Just all around, a lot of smart options.
Yeah, just catching him out of things. Like, a lot of just throwing off Nameless's momentum, right? Because Diddy likes his momentum and his movement, but Ganon's just shutting out his options.
And I think Nameless as a player builds up off that momentum a lot, too.
Exactly. I think Ganon the Beast is aware of that, so he focuses on stopping that. There we go.
Beautiful charge shot.
Yeah, caught him jumping. That was not a good position for Nameless to be in.
I think Ganon's also been... At least in that game, there was very good work keeping him separated from his banana. Just about every time that Diddy would get the banana out, he would immediately kind of force him to the other side of the stage and time it out on him.
So. I barely saw the banana even being pulled out in that game, too. Like, the weird amount of, like, zoning pressure that Ganon had was just keeping Nameless in a situation where it was dangerous for him to really go for any setups with it. That's what you gotta do. It's Diddy's bread and butter. Like, he needs that, like, stage control with it.
Yeah.
Or maybe not, like, need it, but it helps him out.
It helps a ton. The banana just gives him a wide variety of options.
Yeah, his character's designed around it. Oof. Nice.
I find the stage choice a bit interesting. I'm not sure I understand it on a well enough level.
I think I like it for just, like, the stage play. I think it gives Nameless, like, more room. And it gives him a bit more of a, like, weird, unpredictable structure with the platforms to just kind of, like, escape around and maybe set up some interesting, like, mix-up situations stage-wise.
Yeah, it could be, like, a personal comfort.
Yeah.
I just feel like I feel like I've seen a lot of off-the-top kills from Ganon the Beast, so to pick a stage with a shorter ceiling to me, you know,
That's true.
You could be picking for your advantage, but it's also to your opponent's advantage in some ways. So.
Totally. To be fair, I think it also maybe he's not too worried because like Samus strings those easily on like Battlefield and Dreamland. Whereas here, the platforms don't work in that like diamond shape.
That's true. So.
So maybe like, I mean, an up-B would still kill pretty early, but I don't think like Ganon will get Nameless to the top as easily on this stage. Yeah. But we'll see. I could be wrong. This is a really close game so far. Ooh, there it is. That rage. Ugh.
Yep.
Such a good option.
Right off the top.
I think that's been most of Ganon's stocks have been up B's just in general today. Yep. Nice.
There it is out of the shield.
It's probably one of Samus's best moves.
Banana timing out in the center of the stage there.
Yep.
It seems that any time Nameless gets a banana out, Ganon has an answer for getting it out of his hand and then keeping him away.
Well, what's interesting, too, he doesn't even, like, pick it up. He leaves it on the ground so Nameless can't pull it out.
Yeah.
Oh, and I don't know if that was Tekkobo. It happened real quick.
I don't know if I saw the flash.
The boom. Yeah. The, like, little sonic boom thing. Yeah, because I think it's like if you just see the smoke, it's not Tekkobo.
Yeah, I think you need to actually see the, whatchamacallit.
Yeah, I don't think that was. Yeah. I don't want to say.
Questionable.
Very good edge guard, though. Very clean backer. And Ganon is looking like he's kind of figured this out.
Yeah, you can see Nameless is a bit shooken up after that one. Oh.
Oh, what?
So,
what?
You know, Nameless has been pulling out the Ganondorf lately.
That's so great. So, I don't know if this is the person to do it against, though.
I would agree with you 100%. However, it came to a shock to everybody at the monthly when everyone was pulling Ganondorf out to try and beat Randall. And
it worked.
And
Rip the dream.
Yeah. So.
The B reverse charge shot in the air. Yeah, Ganon, he's like, you're cute.
Yeah.
This is cute.
There's only one.
The beast. No, good tech.
And
oh, nope, Ganon's heavier. He's going to live that.
Ganon the Beast really demonstrating his in-depth knowledge of his own character there that, he could play against him just as well as he could play as him.
And also, like, beautiful. Not only did he tech that, but he used it as a way to connect a fair. Hey. That was really... It was almost like he had that whole situation planned out ahead of time, like we were saying before.
And
understanding the game moves ahead.
I would believe it with Ganon the Beast. I'm the kind of person that would tech it and then panic, be like, oh my god, I teched it. So,
I'd be like, cool, I'm alive, that's all I care about. Where he's like, no, I'm going to fare now.
Yeah, like, he composed it in his head, like, this is what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. And I just spit, that was gross.
That's okay. Mm-hmm. We did see Nameless get a nice edge guard with a up air that was kind of unexpected. Took Ganon the Beast's stock, so this is doable. Ooh,
good down B. While Ganon the Beast does have the knowledge, it's still Ganondorf, you know.
Yep, exactly. Oh, that's it, though. Well spaced. Good stuff. Yeah. All right. And that's going to be game three, so that's a bracket reset.
Making quick work to reset that bracket.
There we go.
It's exciting to see it. Ganon the Beast clearly learned from his earlier set where Nameless knocked him into losers and brought that knowledge back into that set here. He didn't, he had an answer for the Diddy Kong play. He had an answer for playing against Ganon, so.
Yep, and we are seeing the switch back to Diddy Kong, kind of predicting that Ganon was more of a, like, just feeling it out. Maybe this would work. He's like, nope, it didn't, so I'm going to just go back for the second set here.
Definitely.
Ganon, he just looks like he just came in super refreshed, just kind of like, wiped off his face and splashed some water. He's like, okay, now I know what I'm doing.
Showing us why he is the one.
Yep. Maybe that's why it's his username. Fun. All right. That is his, like, Twitter name, too. Even though, like, more people know him as Ganon the Beast.
Everyone's going to call him Ganon the Beast.
Okay. Yeah, it's just like Ganon the Beast.
Thing.
He's just putting up a wall. Like, he's just like making it so difficult for his opponent to get any traction. I mean, he's got like you know, 70% on him, but I just, like, can't help but watch this and feel like Ganon the Beast has the match more on lock, even if they are close percentage-wise, just of the way he's playing it. You know what I mean?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Ooh, wow.
Yeah,
that, solid edge guard
there. That was
there.
A great challenge,
was
too.
That a rocket?
That was a Nair,
no,
I think,
okay.
actually.
It came out so quick, I couldn't tell, and the way the hand was looking, I was like, he didn't just...
It did look weird. Yeah. I think it was Nair collided with monkey flip kick.
Okay.
And because Nair extends, like, her leg, she has pretty long limbs, so that helps.
That would make sense.
Yep.
Yeah, the long legs were apparent on the Zero Suit part.
Yep.
But.
She's a pretty, like, tall character in which, that's both a disadvantage, but also, like, her reach gives her somewhat of an advantage in certain situations.
Yep. Nameless keeping that banana tight by here.
Ooh. Ooh, nice.
We'll do that. Ganon just so smart about covering this ledge.
Right.
And
occasionally, like, he gets, you know, grab follow-up. Nameless with a good string there, admittingly, but it's just, like, then he'll get back and he'll get control and then he'll start taking the lead again.
And I think it's also just, you know, he's shown so much versatility from Samus that they did not expect to see.
Exactly. I think it's also, a matter of, like, people aren't familiar with this. Because even though we have a few Samus players, like Favor and Requiem, I think Ganon the Beast plays a fairly different Samus.
Yeah.
And also a very optimal one. Like, he understands his, like, situation.
And it's funny. Ganon the Beast has a way of taking non-aggressive characters
and making them aggressive.
Making them just super high-paced.
It's super interesting, when you really think about that. Like, how? Like, that's... Damn. All right. Game two. You know,
When I describe his Ganondorf play, I tell people it's the fastest I've ever seen that character move.
Exactly. Like, and I think that's a true statement. Also, like, I'm getting hyped because, like, we might see Samus win a tournament.
Very cleanly, too, in this grand finals.
Like, we might see... Okay, we're seeing a Sheik switch. I don't blame Nameless for switching. I feel like the Diddy was... not working the greatest for
him. I don't
blame
him either. I almost expected it earlier, but I know they've kind of stayed strong to this no mains unwritten rule they've had tonight. But now that we're in grand finals.
Yeah. You know, I think Nameless has been playing all his characters pretty consistently, though.
Yeah, that's true. I wouldn't call Diddy Kong a secondary.
Yeah, he's always had a Diddy. Yep. That he does pull out, like, he's known to counterpick, right? He's really good at it, so... I do see this definitely working out better than Diddy, matchup-wise. We'll see what he can do as far as working it goes.
And I think Nameless plays his Sheik's different from his Diddy, which is what's great about it, too.
Exactly.
There's people who will pick characters and play them the same, and it's they're different characters, but their styles are similar and you're playing them similar. But he'll actually change his play style between the two.
Very true. Yep, he forces his opponents to adapt, and, you know, that's going to not only be good against other, like, high-level players, but totally can shut down, like, lower-level ones, because adapting is a huge part about, like, what separates good from great.
Definitely.
Oof. All right. But this is, like we've mentioned before, dangerous for Sheik, especially not having the... 50-50s anymore.
Yep.
Is that she's going to suffer in these both people at kill range type of situations where she doesn't have the kill options over the other character in most cases.
Yeah, and it certainly doesn't help either that Samus is kind of heavy too, deceptively. So
that's true.
You don't expect Samus to be as heavy as she is, so when Sheik has a hard time killing in general, to have a heavy character that you want to kill, even off the top, the side, whatever.
Of course.
It's work.
Right. So it's definitely going to take Nameless those risks like he took with that fair earlier. Those, like, really kind of off-the-wall options that are going to work for him. Like, high-risk, high-reward type situations. Ooh, beautiful Nair. Ganon was ready for that. And the, reappearance didn't even... collide with that or affect that at all. That was really good timing.
We did see that great timed Nair there, so it kind of goes against what I'm about to say. But I was gonna say you know, Sheik's recovery options are better than Diddy Kong's, so that may play to NameLess' favor, too. He was getting edgeguarded pretty hard, but to have something more reliable like the Vanish will help him.
Right, I do agree. I think it's more reliable. I think Ganon just had great timing there. Yeah. And Sheik was just a little too deep that she didn't, like, snap to ledge. At least right away. All right, nice forcing the high recovery there. Trying to continue this edge guard, because that's where Sheik is going to get these kills, I think, are the edge guards. Unless she gets, like, a really good read with a smash attack, but that leaves Sheik so open. Oh, okay, or a really good bouncing fish. That, yeah, admittedly came out of nowhere. That was a really good mix-up. Okay. So NameLess is not going down without a fight, proving the character switch is going to benefit him. Let's see if Ganon can adapt, though. He does have some time. And we saw him adapt to his Diddy.
Deep in thought now, I gotta wonder if it's about stage or character. I could see him staying secondary. I don't think he'll switch to Ganondorf.
I think he will stay secondary.
I wonder if he has another character in the pocket that...
Oh, another secondary. I mean, there's Falco. I don't know what Falco could do that's, like, better than Samus in the Sheik matchup, per se, but...
I'm just curious, if anything.
I think mostly the stage switch. I think this is a good idea. Because, I mean, it's like... Yes, there's platforms, but, I mean, it allows, like we've seen before, Samus to have those strings, those vertical strings really easily.
Yeah, like you were saying about when you were comparing them earlier, kind of that diamond shape reliable for the upward kills as opposed to town and city like we just saw.
And, of course, as we say all the time, Battlefield's boundaries are larger, you know, which is cheap. Ooh, all right. That is still pretty good confirm, like, for damage and such. At lower percents, I think. Oh, just out of nowhere, just the down tilt came out, but collided. Oof. All right, good recovery by NameLess, being very aware of Ganon the Beast's edgeguard attempt. Oh, but eats that forward smash, keeping it close. Good stuff by NameLess, a great string. That up air is still really good.
Yeah, it
harder to land, but still great.
Exactly. That's what I appreciate about it now too. You can't just down throw up air and do it to feel like you don't want to do it anymore. Like it's now it's work.
Yeah. I think my favorite thing, too, about the Sheik changes is, like, I've noticed so many Sheik players are getting really creative to the point where, like, I actually, like, you know, have a lot of fun watching the character. The character, like, I feel like was never, like, too bad, and she never bothered me too much, but I think, like, now we're seeing, like, kind of a new, like, wave of, like, Sheik play that's, like, using that, like, burst grenade and the bouncing fish and, like, really... like hard read type of situations.
Yeah, I think
and chases like that, you know.
It gives more credit to the Sheik players, for sure. Like, she had some tools that were a lot better than others before the nerfs.
Right.
But I would not have ever called her easy to play.
Exactly, so, I agree.
And now that they've kind of nerfed her in a way that the skilled players will still show that they're strong, but the fundamental players will drop off the fundamental sheets.
Yep.
So.
Also, thanks forward tilt from Samus.
Yeah.
Yep. Or you're Ganon the Beast and you just play low tiers really well because you just have you just have a great understanding for the game.
Just a mental book of every player's habit.
Oof. See, yeah, I love the way NameLess is using burst grenades to control that space and forcing Ganon into a low or high recovery depending.
Yeah, it's been. Yeah. Been very calculated.
Yeah. But Ganon's ledge mix-ups are so good at the same time. I can never quite, like, think, like, I'm watching this, like, oh, if I were playing him, what would I go for? And I never quite get it right, like, what I think he does at the ledge.
Yeah.
You know, he's just so good at being aware of, like, deceiving his opponents. Oof. Oof. Goes for that spike. That could have, that would have been really clean. This is dangerous. This is a lot of rage, though. Sheik has to be super careful. Oh, the fair. Oh, wow. Just enough, too. little anticlimactic, but we got at least one more game.
Yeah. It it's interesting. The Sheik switch was definitely the right choice for between, you know, not getting camped out anymore, not getting separated from the bananas anymore, a much more reliable recovery. It's helped them a lot in this long run. You know, we've seen those grenade setups to force certain ledge recoveries by Ganon.
Yep.
I'm just curious now how Ganon's going to adapt to this.
For sure. Oh.
Okay.
So oh, that was nameless. I thought that was Ganon. I was like, what?
It was like he just ran it to Sheik from all the other stuff. Was he going back to Diddy? Like,
no, I think he was just kind of
playing.
Do it, playing around, whatever.
Running back to Battlefield?
Yeah, I mean, again, I think it's probably one of the best stage choices that nameless wouldn't ban. Nameless probably banned Duck Hunt, right?
Yeah, I was going to say that would have been, in my mind, what he would have chosen if he had the option.
Of course. I think there's something to say, too, just about the, like, nameless counterpick, is what I like is how much he played Diddy before he switched to Sheik. Like, he really feeled it out and tried to get as, like, much info as he could. And, like, because I feel like a lot of players will, like, switch after one game, and that's is usually because it's best 2 out of 3.
Yep.
But nameless, like, used that whole set to his advantage to, like, not only wait to bring out the Sheik until it really mattered, but, like, also just see what he could do and if he could make the Diddy work at all.
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, I don't play the two characters in a consistent enough way to compare their movesets.
Of course.
But, like, you know, he could be using Diddy to say, you know, if I use this type of approach with Sheik, I could do the same thing using this, and he'll react this way.
Yeah, I think there's something to say about not using your tools until they, like, really matter as well. You know, like, such as things like going for, like, really hard reads in, like, a place where you've never done it before, but then you do it and it catches your opponent off guard, or bringing out a character all of a sudden that no one expects that you feel will do work in a certain situation. All right, so we're playing. This is a very close game, though. You know, I am seeing Ganon adapt a little bit. I think nameless is just keeping up enough where it's he's not getting as overwhelmed as he was with Diddy. Ooh. But
now he got the charge shot that he was working
right
for
the
last game.
Yeah, he did try that again, and that time he got it. And sometimes, like, doing the same thing, at least at, like, this level of play, is a mix-up in itself, because you don't think they're going to try the same thing twice sometimes.
Yeah.
And then they do, and you're like, oh, wow, that does so much shield damage. That was scary.
Yeah, that.
Ooh, good recovery. Got there right away. Like, I don't want to deal with your first grenade at all.
Yeah, I think now
it's not.
Samus is just, it's about camping out a bit and getting as much percent at this point.
Right. Ooh, this looks like we might be going to game 5. Forward to that almost connected. That was really close. Jumping away, staying safe. Good stuff.
Samus at that percent that makes it too hard to follow up a throw.
Ooh, good. I just love his use of Nair. It's so good. He uses it a lot like he does with Ganon. You know, he throws it out as a way to kind of stuff his opponent, opponents who are trying to approach from the air.
Definitely a difficult percent for Sheik to get kills right now.
Yeah, this is a really bad situation for Sheik. Really bad. Oh, okay,
there
this is going to make it better. This is going to make it better. Obviously, but yeah, like, Sheik has a hard time with Rage because she'll build up percent and then...
It's just like we saw with that Bouncing Fish. You just kind of got to go for something and get it because your follow-ups are gone at that point.
Right. And then the moment you stop, like, respecting your player, your opponent's, like, really powerful options, you're going to get, like, a Rage Smash attack. And you're also, Sheik is really light and did get lighter with the nerfs, too.
Yeah, so that, you know, she can't sleep on a Samus Smash attack.
Yeah, or any, like, Smash
attack. But, you know, I find with Rage, Samus will hit you pretty hard.
The forward smash does do some pretty good knockback.
You know, that could just be coming from my experiences as a light fox getting, you know, destroyed by a smash attack.
Yeah.
But
same. I play, like, nothing but light characters, so I feel you.
Yeah.
Oof. But, okay, like, nameless has brought this back, though. Like, I gotta commend him for that. He's, like, doing work now.
Yeah, he was in a...
Ooh, but the tilt. Forward tilt, boys. Shout out to the buff. I think that was, like... It's been a few times he's killed with a Vortil, actually, like, by at the edge of the stage.
Yeah.
Well-spaced. Upward angle, so it catches, like, someone coming onto the stage.
You know, it goes back to what I was saying earlier. Ganon's just showed us so many different types of ledge covering options with Samus. It's really neat. I've seen him cover it with down smashes, with tilts, with
fully charged shot.
You know, it's he's forced different types of approaches. Mm-hmm. It's really, really interesting to see how many options Samus really has when we're not used to seeing this level of play.
Right. Oh, okay, we're seeing switch back to Diddy. I'm not sure about that. Maybe it's more like he just doesn't feel comfortable enough to try Sheik again.
Could be.
I really want to know the mentality behind this.
I do too. I wonder if I don't know how much it matters to him, but I wonder if he banned a stage that he wanted with Sheik and so
that
he's
could
more
be.
Comfortable on a stage with Diddy.
That could be. But maybe it's a like, I got you used to Sheik, so here's Diddy. I don't know for sure. I mean, he's doing work right now. He's got a really good percentage lead.
Yeah, I think for the first time in both sets, had some actual time to really use the banana.
Yeah, I'm not sure, but he's doing work with it. Yeah, he's like really up in Ganon the Beast's grill this time. He's like, the pressure game is really on right now. And I mean, the stakes are high, so
yeah,
I kind of understand it.
That high pressure on Samus' play was working for him when he took Ganon out earlier today. Took him out of the winner's bracket.
Right.
So,
oof. But here we go, Ganon the Beast coming back. He's got that reach. There he goes. Nice nair. That looks so flashy. Run off nair. It looks so fun. She's just like, spin. Now you're dead.
There's too many naircopters in this game already to call it that, so I don't even know what to call it.
I'm like,
it spun around, but everybody's got their little spins. So.
Oh, that's funny. I actually haven't heard that too much. That's fun,
I guess nairplane is more what people call it.
Or fair plane.
Fair plane,
yep. But I like that naircopter.
Yeah,
up smash. I love the way he uses up smash as a great like anti-air option. And Nameless is like, I have one too. there goes your stock. It's fine. It's interesting too because it's like in kind of the weird like general playstyle how they're these two players are going about it because Nameless supplied the pressure really early in this game. I feel like he's gotten more space to get that banana.
Yeah.
You know, like I'm seeing it used more than it was in the first set.
That's really been helping.
Ooh, and this is how he's getting his setups, and this might cost Ganon this tournament. This is game right here. Last stock. Ooh. See what happens. Ooh, monkey flip. I don't know. Looking for that chase. Oh, Ganon the Beast, got to charge that. Not quite enough, but that's going to be big damage.
Yeah, this is about it now.
Yeah, this is the wire. Not quite. That was so close, though. Right at the edge. Ganon the Beast trying to get some space to breathe. Oh, that's it. No, it's not. Not Smashville. That was scary.
Yeah, Nameless coming out real strong this match.
Okay, good mix up with the grab. Can he get that guard?
Again,
Nameless, smart recovery.
Banana again.
Ooh, that's it. The confirm.
Yep.
Oh wow, that was so cool.
That was a very intense set, and classic Diddy confirm to finish it off.
That was like teeth clenching at the end there. Like, both of them were just looking for, like, something. They were both, like, so, like, in their heads. But Nameless is going to take another level up tournament.
Okay.